So for on any question, you can use those three things. Like, for example, should marijuana be legal? Well, you look on reciprocity. That doesn't really apply on that one, I don't think so much. Consequentialism is, well, this is where one might argue, well, if we legalize marijuana, it could result in, you know, a lot of accidents or people destroying their lives. And somebody else might say, you know, it would improve their life, especially if they have illnesses or something. Some other people might say, hey, just it's a good way to enjoy life, taking some legal drugs. And then the other one is individual rights. So for example, the idea there is as long as it doesn't hurt anybody, then people are free to do what they want to do. So, you know, if you want to do it and you're not causing trouble or it's not going to hurt anybody else, then what you do in your private time is fine. So how would you figure out, like, if marijuana, you know, that's a moral issue, should marijuana be legal in Oregon or not? How do you determine what the right moral answer is on that?
Well, let's see. Did God create marijuana?
Yeah. You know,
that, okay. There you go. So he created it.
So yeah.
Huh?
So your answer is he created it. So yes, it's okay.
Yeah. I mean, it's just there are a lot of different things that could be that could fall under your excess. You know, and so yeah, if excess causes people to be so stoned that they can't drive well, then that's a problem. So, but you know, there's many religions, like, you know, the Indians and the peace pipe.
Yeah, and peyote also. I mean, it's a hallucinogenic drug.
Right.
So you have the same opinion that as long as it doesn't really hurt anybody, it's fine because God made it?
Yeah, and it might even help. I'm come from being a hippie, and so obviously I was a musician, so obviously I tried marijuana, and what it did for me was it relaxed me to the point where I said, wow, why don't I feel this way all the time?
Mm-hmm.
And that inspired my whole search into psychology and religion.
Now what about cocaine then, for example?
Yeah, cocaine's bad.
Well, but it's the same thing. God made it, didn't he?
No, he made the coca plant, but he didn't make refined cocaine. That has to go through.
Well,
a process.
He made the marijuana plant, but it, you know, we had to smoke it
or eat it.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I guess you could just eat it. That's true. I was gonna say you have to cook it, but I guess you could eat it raw if you want salad.
Right. Sure, people used to put it in spaghetti and all that, and brownies and.
One thing to beware of, though, there's a called a naturalistic fallacy, where some people say if it's natural, it's good. But then, you know, the counterpoint to that is, well, you know, uranium is natural. It's radioactive. It'll kill you.
And poison mushrooms.
Yeah. So I mean, is your argument that if you could eat it, then it's fine? I mean,
yes, right. Too, it's a spice. If you look at it as a spice, I mean, there are a lot of things that people eat, like jalapenos and stuff that I can't handle.
Uh-huh.
That could be, you know, harmful to the digestive tract and all that.
That's interesting. I never heard that argument before. So, if it's a drug and you can eat it, then it should be fine.
Well, not necessarily. I mean, it's like I said,
in moderation.
Poison mushrooms.
What? Know? What about mushrooms?
You know, poison mushrooms.
Oh, what about the psilocybin mushrooms?
Yeah, that's.
Those are good.
Yeah.
Yeah, those are those.
I'm not proposing that these things are good, because I've had some of the worst times of my life on that kind of stuff.
Yeah, but God made it though, so. Interesting. I'm not clear on your answer. So, like, let's say, for example, psychedelic mushrooms. That's good in moderation, you're saying? That's okay?
Well, I guess. I'd have to think about it. I've had some of the best nights of my life on them, and I've had some of the worst nights of my life on them, which caused, you know, years of damage, years of emotional damage and, well, and psychological damage.
So how do you determine morality if another Christian says to you, like, no drugs at all, you know? I mean, like, the Mormons are very extreme. They don't even want to drink hot drinks, I think, which, you know, basically is like caffeine. They don't even want to drink coffee or something. So, I mean, if a Christian says to you, no, it's against God's law to take drugs at all because it puts you in a different state of mind, how do you say, like, well, no, that's not God's law? I mean, how do you figure out what God's law is or God's morality on that?
Well, I think this gets into your third leg then, personal experimentation. We should have freedom for that. And, like, I mean, Jesus made wine at the wedding. And, mm-hmm. you know, even the Bible says wine makes your heart merry.
Right.
But I don't drink wine. I don't drink anything. And I don't take any drugs. I haven't done so for many years. I don't feel the need for them. So, you know, that there's the interpretation, intellectual interpretation. But then there's also the physical reality. And that's what my physical reality has led me to.
Yeah, I know some Baptists, or maybe even most or many of them, I don't know, but a lot of them, they don't drink wine at all. And it's like you said, Jesus turned water into wine at the wedding. And it's like, well, that's because their water wasn't, I don't know, it's like they don't want to admit it, you know? It's like,
no, I know, I've been through that. Some people say it's grape juice, and but no, it's definitely wine, because the Bible talks a lot about excess with wine. Don't get drunk. You know?
Yeah, and they said, according to the parable, it says, or the story, it says it was the best wine too. So,
right, there you go.
Okay, so let's go on to the next one. The next section is.